Okay, so here we go. Hey everyone, it's Daniel here. I'm currently at a high school. I'm supposed to be counseling one of the kids that's struggling with some anxiety. And I just thought maybe this is a good opportunity for me to do a little bit of a video about anxiety. So if you're struggling with anxiety, it's real. I get it. I also have my moments with anxiety. I just want to start off with saying that it's such a natural thing, actually. Anxiety, fear is a natural response that the body has, and we shouldn't really want it to be over, because it's also something that protects you. It's something that guides you, that helps you to stay alive. And that's simply what it's all about, right? So you think that your anxiety is crippling, but actually something somewhere happened in your life that caused you to create this belief that if I'm placed in a certain situation or placed in a certain area, or if I'm in a certain place, that will cause my death to the worst extent. And so what your brain does subconsciously, it's this whole process of saying, I need to protect myself, I need to cope, and the best way to cope is to withdraw. And now anxiety is tricky in the sense that you know that this thing is crippling you. You're not going out meeting new people, you're not going for that job interview, you're not putting yourself out there, you're not starting that business, you're not doing what you are dreaming about because of these things, because of the anxiety, right? So what do we do? And there's this, it's maybe it's a little bit of semantics, but the trick is not to stop fearing or not to have anxiety. The trick is to become braver. How do we become braver? Is by slowly but surely exposing ourselves to the things we fear, to the things that make us anxious. It's not avoiding them, because that's not the answer. It's slowly but surely approaching it and addressing it face on. Because the anxiety won't go away, but you will become stronger and you will start overcoming those things. The tool I want to leave with you is SOS. So right, when you're in danger, you scream SOS, or you which is the signal for help. I'm in danger. So think anxiety equals danger equals SOS. SOS is an acronym for stop, observe, and shift. So the first thing is that you need to identify what is this fear. Where is it coming from? Inside the anxiety, especially if you've got it bad and you're actually having an attack, you're not going to do anything there. You need to practice breathing, practice skills, and probably avoid that situation in that moment. But then you need to start asking yourselves, okay, stop for a moment. Why am I fearing? What is the thing I'm fearing? And is this rational? Is this a rational belief? Can this thing actually kill me? If I speak to the girl, will that cause the end of my life? Or am I just so scared of failure? Or am I so scared of rejection? And the sad thing is that the more you live in anxiety, the more those things become the truth. And you actually start being rejected because you withdraw. You actually start being alone because you withdraw. So the anxiety has an effect, but not because you believed thing that, or the fear that you believed is actually happening. It's like this self prophecy that because you fear something, you act in a certain way and you withdraw. So let's not do that. Let's stop, examine, observe. Why do I believe what I believe? and then shift. So either you shift away from that situation, but in your mind, your thinking needs to change about the situation, and then you need to shift, maybe shift into it, face on, face the thing, take it step by step, and realize anxiety, fear is not your enemy, it's there to protect you. When that fear becomes crippling, it's irrational, and you need to expose yourself to that fear to become braver. Stop, observe, shift. Guys, I hope that you find some benefit in this video. I just thought while I was going to speak to someone about it, I might just help someone else this morning. So have a good one. Cheers.